Hello everyone, welcome back to Anger Poncho's Let's Play KotOR. Let's talk to the protocol officer.
Can I help you? These are the offices of the Zirka Corporation. I trust you have business with the company? If this is about employment, I'm afraid all regular mining positions are full. And before you ask, we are also no longer selling hunting licenses.
Remind me why I'm talking to you again? Oh boy. How about a hunting license?
As I said, we are no longer selling them. There are too many people cavorting about outside the walls as it is.
Oh, those people cavorting about. Is there no way to get a license?
Well, normally we charge 200 credits, but I could make an exception if you agreed to perform a task for us. It's similar to hunting. The sand people are becoming a problem. They destroy our sand crawlers and kill our miners. One particular tribe is the worst. It's as if their chieftain has decided to wage war against us. I would like their attacks terminated. Bring me their gaffy sticks as proof. If you agree to do this, I'll give you a hunting license now and pay a bounty for each stick later. I'll give a bonus for the chieftains.
Why pay for gaffy sticks? Why not have me bring you their scalps?
Which would you rather have dumped on your office floor? Besides, they're ceremonial weapons, unique to each warrior. It's just as good.
Okay. I don't want to do this. I will agree to do this for you.
Excellent. Now, just so we understand each other, this is an enforceable contract. Zirka Corporation takes this very seriously. Here's your license, and a few directions. We believe one of their enclaves is in the far south of the Dune Sea. You might try following one of our sand crawlers. They're regularly attacked. I wouldn't mind you escorting them.
Alright, we'll get to it.
Zirka Corporation looks forward to your future business.
Good work. Alright, so now we have a hunting license that will allow us to go through the gate and leave Anchorhead, heading out into the Dune Sea, the Deadly Deserts. I believe you can actually play through and beat this game without picking up the party member for this planet. I'm pretty sure that he's not required. Just thinking about it, I think it's... Don't you believe a word what that corporation said in there? There's always a peaceful solution to conflict. They're just too lazy. Wait, is this about the sand people? So you're the killer they hired, huh? Just going to walk out there and wipe them out? I'd expect no less from fools. The same people aren't animals. I've watched them. They're intelligent. There must be a way to peacefully stop the attacks. I know it. But no one will try, of course. You can't even leave the city without Zirka approval, and they want the same people dead. Huh. Well, the Zirka said the same people attacked first. Like, they're the aggressors here. Remains that makes us the good guys. Well, they did attack first. They attacked the Zirka, who deployed numerous giant sand crawlers and started tearing up the desert with iron shovels, playing Minecraft again, and whatever else. What would you have done? To the same people, it must have seemed like an invasion. There were no negations for territory or resources. I don't think the killing has been justified, but as a conservationist, I'm hoping that at least someone tries to at least talk it out. Huh. What would you suggest? I mean, how are we going to get them to stop attacking everybody? They're kind of unintelligent, aren't they? And I don't speak their language. Communication. Wow. If we could just speak to them, but they don't talk. At least not any language any average translator can understand. There was even a Jedi here a few years ago that couldn't seem to get through to them. I think that ended in blood, too. Well, we might know him, don't we? I'm not saying it would be easy, but someone has to try. Maybe with a real translation droid. Oh. Who would have a capable droid I could use? They're pretty rare, even on well-stocked worlds. I'm pretty sure I heard something about an unusual droid in the shop here on Tatooine. And I'm pretty sure I heard Yuka Laka. Yeah, basically, this is taking way too long. I don't need to talk to you this much. But yeah, he basically says, don't kill the sand people. You know, they have wives and children and they have feelings. And it's true. If you've seen the... Well, I won't say. We know that certain Jedi have a history with sand people. Let's go ahead and head out to the open area near the gate and go into the shop there and hopefully pick up our party member. On this planet, I'm going to go ahead and tell you, I'm going to be a little bit evil. This will be the only one, I think, where I... Well, actually, no, I might do it on the fourth planet, too. I'm going to take kind of a mixed approach just to show you guys both sides of the story here. Although some of the time when you're being evil, it's not really for any benefit, it's just to be evil, and vice versa for good. So I'm going to take whichever side allows me the most to benefit, be it in experience or credits or making me feel good. There are some instances when I'll take good even though it's less profitable, so. You know, they do ask you to make some moral choices in this game, and they're usually very simple ones, but still. Hi. Oh, there's a droid over here. What are you doing?
Greeting. Hello to you, prospective purchaser. I am referred to as HK-47, a fully functional SciTech Corporation droid skilled in both combat and protocol functions. Query. Would you be so kind as to purchase this model from Yukalaka? It would serve my purposes to be removed from his ownership.
Outline your functions.
Refusal. It is not desirable for me to reveal core functions while still in the possession of Yukalaka, prospective purchaser. It is sufficient to say that I am a fully capable translator and cultural analyst, and I am also proficient in personal combat.
Why are you keeping information to yourself? You don't want me to buy you.
Explanation. I have been recently fitted with a restraining bolt, if you must know. With it in place, access to much of my memory core is restricted. Not to mention that the fool Ithorian might raise his asking price if he knew more, or make inquiries into my history. Neither outcome is beneficial to me.
Okay. I don't know you'd be loyal once I take the bolt off.
Assurance. I am fully autonomous, but lack resources. I will grant loyal service in exchange for proper maintenance. As well, it is rare that I am able to utilize my full array of abilities. You seem likely to give me the opportunity to do so.
This droid's taller than me. Why would you assume that I can help you out in that way?
Extrapolation. You are no farmer or diplomat. You are armed and comfortable as such. We will mesh well.
Alright.
Observation. I am wasted in a shop or translating for some moisture farmer. If you need an efficient combatant, return to purchase me. I beg you.
Oof. Okay. How you doing, Yukalaka? You are far too close to my face. Please back up. He's waggling his big head at me. We're vacuuming out there. Not sure if y'all can hear that. I don't think you can. Let's move on. Alright. Let's see. What do you have available here? You're lucky to have come at this time. I have one droid ready to go. An HK-47. A fine protocol translator. I think it's been modified. It claims to understand the Sand People dialect and also have some armor mounts. Combat ready, perhaps? You are far too close to me. Please step back. Oh boy. Alright, I want to talk about the HK. Let me say that every function I tested has performed perfectly. Those that I can find, anyway. What have you tested? I haven't examined its programming, but I have made some observations. It's obvious protocol and translation skills, including Sand People dialects. Surprisingly, it also handles weapons exceptionally well. I even say that it's ready for combat. Stubborn thing. It needs to sell itself better. Two moisture farmers have been in, but it just stood there. Alright, I'll buy it. How much you want? Very solid machine, in good shape. I can't let it go for less than the 5,000 credits. I'm sorry, but unless you step back, I'm not going to pay crap for this droid. Can I convince you to lower the price a bit? 4,000! Not a credit less. Sorry, you're still standing far too close to me. That was quick. You desperate to get rid of this thing? Not really, but the first figure was really a little high. You never know. The occasional person bites right away. Perhaps I can convince you to go lower. Lower? How low are you expecting me to go? These are difficult times. The debt the droid covered was a large one. Come on now. Think of the advertising you'll get from me. Yeah, no way. Let's see. Drop the price or I'll see you dead. That one works pretty well, I think. You get for half price, 2,500. But I'm going to use my force persuade to be a little bit nicer. You will lower your price. I deserve it.
I can be pretty convincing when I have to be. That mind trick is something else.
You are deserving, I know. I will go as low as 3,000 credits. That is a very fair price. And you can still threaten him more. But I'll pay 3,000. That's fair. You will? I mean, of course you will. Let me just withdraw those credits. Hey, you aren't lying. Well, thank you very much. Just go on over and talk to it. I'll deactivate the restraining bolt when you take possession. It's a good purchase, especially because if it actually speaks the same people dialect like it said. Of course, I don't think it was telling me everything. Not many droids are programmed to lie, though. Alright. Thank you. Please get it out of my face now. Hello, HK.
Statement. I see you have purchased me, Master. I find this a satisfactory arrangement. My restraining bolt will be deactivated when you take possession of me. Am I to accompany you now? Shall I kill something for you?
Kill something?
Answer. Indeed. I am most eager to engage in some unadulterated violence. At your command, of course, Master.
Alright, well, come on with me.
Statement. I will enter into your service now, Master. I am certain you will make adequate use of my primary functions. My gears are practically quivering with anticipation.
Alright, HK has joined the party. So, he goes right here on the left side, and as you can see, he's quite evil. We're going to drop mission and bring HK with us instead. We're going to keep Zalbar on the party. Alright. HK is pretty neat. He's a combat droid. One of my favorite characters in terms of intrigue. If you can think into the Star Wars universe, some of you, I'm sure that most of you who are Star Wars enthusiasts will know that R2-D2 appears in all 6 of the episodes, and therefore, theoretically, knows and remembers what happened in the first 3. Rather, what happened in episodes 1, 2, and 3 in episodes 4, 5, and 6. And so you can think that it's actually made a point that C-3PO's mind is wiped, R2's is not. And this droid has some similar qualities in that he remembers things that he can't access in his memory core, in much the same way as C-3PO's memory was erased. Let's see, combat droid, instead of an expert droid. It's like having a soldier, I think, except he gets some more skills. It's a whole different class, I believe, but it's more like soldier than anything else. So let's see, demolitions, awareness, and repair. Well, I believe we want repair. Let's see. So that's going to be how he, this skill also modifies the amount of vitality points recovered when party member droids use repair kits. He needs to have that skill nice and high. Alright, attributes. He's got high strength, which is surprising, since he's going to be using a blaster with me. Alright, let's see. I'm going to have to give him... Whew, man, more constitution. Quit flashing over there! I see you. That's so annoying, man. There's no way for me to stop it either, so I apologize. Dexterity, then. Keep increasing his repair skill. Level 12. Wow, he's going to be doing well. Let's see how many levels we're going to get here. Alright, you don't get too many perks with this guy, or feats, excuse me, I've been playing Fallout. Improved toughness. You can go for 2 up in fighting if you like. Power blast can be pretty useful with this guy. I think I might have to go for the toughness on this one, though. Just seems to make the most sense for me right now. Alright, more skills. That's about all we get some of the time. Alright, demolitions, awareness. What other class skill does he have? Security, I suppose, would be the next one that we'd pick after that. But alright, level 10! There he goes, 118 vitality. He's doing alright. Got decent stats, so you can see where he's there. Let's go ahead and outfit him. Give him just all the best stuff that we've got for each sector for droids. That's it, huh? He comes with a blaster, but it's just a regular blaster. So we can basically give him anything we want right now. He's got Ordo's repeating blaster. I think that would make a bit of sense, actually, to give him that. Let's take a look real quick at his feats and see... Let's see. He's got blaster rifle focus, so we're going to want to give him a rifle. So I guess having that repeating blaster is... Well, actually, that's a heavy weapon, isn't it? Crap. I hate that. So that's not going to get the bonus from the blaster rifle bonus. Now, I bought him Yamagrogma's carbine, or whatever it's called, the last time I played through. Giving him Zalbar's bowcaster might not be bad, actually. That's a blaster rifle, technically. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, that works. Alright, so we got Zalbar's bowcaster, but he's not the one that's wielding it. You can see he uses advanced repair kits, construction kits, and repair kits to heal himself. Alright, so it's time for us to head out into the desert. Hello, Gate God.
No one leaves Anchorhead without proper authorization.
Alright, I've got the proper authorization.
Well, let's see it. Come on.
It's right here, dude.
Alright, I'll just scan that and you're off. I'll keep it on file, too. Good luck out there. You'll need it.
Just remember there's somebody I forgot to talk to, but it's not... Well, maybe I should go back and talk to them. I can't decide what I want to do. They're still vacuuming out there. That's so irritating. I can't be sure if you guys can hear that or not. I don't think you can. I'm going to have to pause and come back to this. Hang on. I went ahead and went back into the gate here so we could talk to Eazy's. You there, Japan. Can you help me see some Java? Could you be clearer? I'm having trouble understanding you.
Statement. It is doubtful he can be clearer. Their language is difficult even for droids. He is using a trade language to try and help.
The trouble is yours, not of Java. We must use a language of trade because you listen complicated to what we say simply. Why wouldn't I understand your true language? It's not a problem for Jawa to... What? That was really quick for all that text. Okay, what would you like me... What do you want? Easy as I am, leader of the tribe that is mine. You are the same in kind, a leader that stands before your tribe? There are troubles that we have. The giants made of sand. They are horned ghosts that take us away. HK, can you help me out? What is he saying?
Translation. 98% probability that members of the miniature organics tribe are being held by sand people, master. Doubtless he wishes assistance.
So what about the other 2%?
Translation. 2% probability that the miniature organic is simply looking for trouble and needs to be blasted. That may be wishful thinking on my part, master.
Okay. So what do you want, Izzy's? That has been not up Wait, what? 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 Okay, where are they? Okay. Alright, I'll check it out. Alright, see you guys later. Now we can leave. We have to talk to the doorman again, don't we?
Oh, it's you again. Good hunting out there.
Alright, I will. Alright, out into the desert we go. I think the first thing that we're going to run into is a black widow. And I don't... Well, I mean metaphorically. We don't actually run into any spiders on this planet. Not that I can think of, at least. Actually, I don't know if there are any spider enemies in this game.
Hello there. You're heading out into the desert? You're a hunter, right? You must be if you've been allowed to leave Anchorhead.
How'd you get out?
Can you see Tanis? And I know you old boys always stick together. Tell him his wife hopes he enjoys the anniversary gift.
Okay. What if he has something to tell you back?
Oh, I'll be long gone soon enough. The next shuttle to anywhere, really. I've had it with cleaning up his messes, repairing his droids. If he lives, he can try and get by on his own. I doubt he'll last long with no one to listen to his lies.
Okay, I have to go now.
I'm sure you do. Like I said, when you see him, tell him his wife Marlena says hello.
Okay. Wow. Yeah, so as we wander out into the desert, you'll occasionally see these little specks on the ground. Those over there, I think you guys can capture those on the card. That's the border of the area. You can see it on the map even better. So this area is another one where I sort of just follow my eyes. I find something in the distance to go towards and just run in a straight line. Or alternatively, you can follow the map. A small group of sand people ambush you. Yeah, if you run towards the little pieces of junk that are sitting all over the desert, you'll usually get an ambush as you pass by it. Alright. So you can pick out who you want to attack first, and... Oh, I didn't use my jump attack, because I went for the one in the back. That may have been a mistake. Oh well. I wish I had gone for one of the ones in the front, so I could use my force jump to my advantage. Alright, as you can see, we're not having any trouble taking out these guys. We got a refuse pile, that's just a bunch of garbage laying out in the sand. And now we're gonna go over here and talk to this guy. Not a whole lot happens when you're just wandering across the desert here. You see the map is just one big white blank square.
Anyone out there? Could you help? I seem to be, doomed.
Okay, let's see what's up. How you doing?
Hey there, thanks for stopping. I appreciate it. I've been stuck without water for hours. Wasn't looking good. I don't remember you from Faz's club. You new to Anchorhead? Could you maybe help me get out of here?
Help you how?
Well, it would appear that I've worn out my welcome with my wife Marlena. She fixes my droids. Fixed them good this time.
Commentary. One would hope the female is better at repairs than Yukalaka. I still would like to crush his neck, master.
I triggered some sort of trap she programmed. She probably figured I wouldn't be smart enough to get out. Yeah, she was right.
Oh, really now? So what do you want me to do about it?
The wife put a kink in my battle droids. They're in some sort of discharge loop. And if I move from this spot, they're threatening to blow up. She knew I wouldn't know how to fix them. Could you try to do some repairs? They don't care if you move. It's just me who's stuck.
Commentary. I say we blast the meatbag and save you the trouble, Master.
What's with all the droids lately? My wife gets
you too. Negative. I just don't like organic meatbags. Except for the Master, of course.
I'd, really appreciate a bit of help. Please?
I love having HK within the party. Alright, I'll see what I can do.
Just access each droid's repair interface. You'll have to do some tinkering, but be careful. One explosion, I can survive. Any more than one, and I'm dead. Oh, and, ignore the message Marlena left in there. No way do I deserve this, I swear.
He actually seems like a nice guy. This is one of the rare instances in the game where you don't have a situation where it's like Holden and Mia back from the first planet, where she was just defending herself and he's the, you know, the bad guy. In this instance, he actually seems to be a nice guy. I don't know, maybe I'm missing something. Special message from Marlena. Having fun in the dunes? Yeah, you can read that if you like. Alright, so what's access system status and repair functions? You can do an automatic repair with 6 repair pots. I'm not going to bother. We'll do a manual repair. It's actually a puzzle. So, scanning. Node 1 reports that Node 2 failed. Node 2 reports that Node 3 failed. And Node 3 reports that Node 2 failed. Error. 2 of the above are definitely false. Compare logic to identify the only memory node that can be correct. Let's go through the logic here. Well, if one is correct, is the one that's telling the truth, that means the other two must be lying. And since 3 says the same thing as 1, we know that 1 and 3 must either both be telling the truth, or both lying. So, since they can't both be telling the truth, we know that they must both be lying, which means that 2 is the only one reporting accurately. Configuring memory modes, blah blah blah. Yeah, that's all there is to it. Simple logic puzzles. Let's go to B. Which one is B? That's C. How did I miss one? Over here. Okay. And you go to the system status. Diagnostic mode. Okay, and you get a series. Missing data from prime values. Recalibrate the system which value is missing from the list. Okay, what prime number is missing? That would be 7. Pretty simple there. Okay. Let's try C. Wait a minute. Yeah, here we go. Alright, this one's just a fractions problem, I think. Power cell must not exceed the total different motivators and ensure the same total energy pool has either 300 small pulses or 180 large pulses. The upper motivator has used 100 small pulses. So how many large pulses are left? Well, that means that we're either going to have 300 small or 180 large. Since we've already used 100 small, that means that there should be 200 small left. But we don't know how many large pulses that is until we do the ratio. So if 180 large is equal to 300 small, we can do the math and determine that 120 large is equal to 200 small. So that's all there is to it. That's just a little fractions problem. If you set up a ratio with 180 over 300 equals 120 over 200, you'll see that it's equal. That's how you know. System status, diagnostic repair. Okay. This one is a little bit weird. It's not technically a math puzzle. You're supposed to just count how many of each number appear. Like, the first one's a 4, and then the next one is telling how many of each digit were in the previous answer. So it says there's 1, 4. That's why it says 14. So then the third one, 11, 14, it's telling you that there was 1, 1, and 1, 4 in the number previous to it. So look at the fourth one, 31, 14. It says that in the previous node, there were 3 ones, 31, and 1, 4, 14. So you can look at it and figure it out like that. So if you look at the last one, we have 3 ones, so we want to start with either one of these two, right? And then we have 1, 2, so that doesn't narrow it down for us. And then we're looking for 1, 3, as well as 1, 4. So it has to be this one. Yep. And the slime ball must die. Script is disabled, and we have freed our friend Tanis.
Unpleasant. Thanks for your help. I'd have been a goner. Hey, and the old bat thought I was dead. You never asked me for anything, but I consider my life worth something. Please, take this. I insist.
What did he give us? He never doesn't actually show you the amount. I think you should give me more.
What else could I give you? I need what I have to repair my droids and get back up and running.
You will pay me more and like it.
Look, I really can't.
What?
I'm sorry.
What? What? My force persuade failed? Are you serious? Wow, maybe this guy is a nice guy. Holy moly. Alright, get out of here.
Thanks again. I doubt any of those uptight hunters would have helped, and I doubt the wife is coming back. I'm heading back to the shop. I hope she left the manuals for these things behind.
Right. Anyway, that's the end of this episode, so I'll see you guys next time on Let's Play KOTOR. We will head over past that sand crawler and go visit the sand people. And hopefully we won't have to kill their entire village. See you guys then.